أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إنا أعطيناك الكوثر فصل لربك وانحر إن شانئك هو الأبتر صدق الله العظيم السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Welcome to another episode of Understanding the Message of the Majestic Quran. What is this book of Allah have for me? What can I take from it? What are the moral lessons in it for me? How does it spiritually connect me with my Creator and with my Lord? How does it encourage me to serve others? How does it help me to become a better human being? Well, my dear listeners and viewers, today I've chosen Surah Al-Kawthar, the shortest surah of the Quran, and this is what it says. Listen, in the name of Allah, the kind, the caring, we gave to you everything in abundance. Therefore, pray to your Lord and sacrifice. It's your enemy who is going to be finished off and cut off. Well, these three short verses of Surah Al-Kawthar were regarded by the Makkan poets as being amazing, incredible. And the person who saw them first, one of the poets, said, this is not the kalam of any human being. This is not a speech of a human being. In other words, it is inimitable. And so, but what is the surah saying? Well, and when was it revealed? Well, we know that Surah Al-Kawthar was revealed after the Prophet, may peace and blessings of Allah be upon him, lost two of his baby boys, Qasim and Abdullah. And you can just imagine, you know, two baby boys dying, how much hurt and the Prophet would have felt, how sad he would have been, the bereavement, the grieving of his. You know, can you feel the pain in his heart and how he would be suffering? However, the Quraysh leaders, and particularly Abu Lahab, was jubilant. Can you imagine how callous and insensitive he was? He celebrated this, and the other enemies of Rasulullah were jubilant. See, Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam will have no male heirs. Therefore, his mission will finish. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent these three verses, encouraging him, giving him hope, and really reassuring him that his mission will be successful. Subhanallah. You know, can you imagine that being in such bereaving state, yet Allah reassures and consoles his beloved. Don't worry, Muhammad. Inna a'twaynaka al-kawthar. We have blessed you with plenty. We have given you so much. You have abundance. Now, here it doesn't say what things Allah has given him, because everything, all the favors that you can imagine, Allah says, we have given you. Now, if I was to use that for myself and for you, that would mean you have got Kawthar. You too have so much. And alhamdulillah, that is right. You know, Allah has blessed all of us with so much that, you know, the Quran says, وَإِن تَعُدُّوا نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ لَا تُحْصُوهَا. Were you to count and enumerate the blessings of Allah, you wouldn't be able to do them, because they are so many. And what should we do then? Well, the Quran says very simply, فَصَلِّ لِرَبِّكَ وَانْحَرْ. Pray to your Lord, make sacrifices. Subhanallah. You know, connect with Allah through zikr, through salah, through five daily prayers. And also serve humanity. Make sacrifices for your neighbors, for your relatives, for your family. And then what will happen? Then very simply, inna sha'naka. Your enemy is the one who will be finished off. He will be childless. He will lose. He will have nothing. In other words, you know, Allah is encouraging us to be positive even in the most dire states.